अनूठा इंडिया में बानू पटेल जी का स्वागत है। बानू जी, आप अपने बारे में, अपने एजुटेनमेंट प्रोग्राम के बारे में और आज के प्रोग्राम के बारे में बताइए।
मैम, मैं एक्चुअली प्रिंसिपल थी एक CBSE स्कूल की। अब मुझे ग्लैमर में बहुत इंटरेस्ट है एंड आई हैव आल्सो बीन द विनर ऑफ अ ब्यूटी पेजेंट, मिसेस ब्यूटी पेजेंट। एंड देयरफॉर फिर आशा जी ने हमें आज इनवाइट किया है कि यू विल बी द राइट पर्सन टू जज एवरीबॉडी। Also, like, you know, she has been my, let's say, inspiration to lose weight. So, I have lost weight from 68. Today, I'm 54. And since I'm related to the field of education, I have started this edutainment programs, which is going to bring about holistic and all-round development in pupils, which is ABACUS, speech and drama, related to grammar classes and faculty development programs and cybersecurity, everything related to edutainment, because nowadays the children, they're very different.
Exactly.
Education has become very complex, very dynamic, and therefore you have to change the how aspect, the technique of education. You have to make it very interactive and interesting for them. So we are giving them informal education, wherein we are trying to instill the values of, like, let's say, all-round development. We are trying to make them productive human beings and also humane
individuals. Are you contacting the schools for this edutainment? Like, how you are reaching to the students? Because actually this is a, I mean, very, very big problem, because actually nowadays, I mean, children are really very much into mobiles.
Yes.
And of course, because there are two aspects, good and bad, both. So if they catch the good one, nothing like it. But if they catch the bad one, so it disturbs the whole family. So, like, what do you say about it?
Well, I would say that I have been in this field of education. So the problem is that, see, you have to be as them. You have to be as per their age. You must know that what they want, not what you want. And then you have to change yourself according to them and see to it that how you can bring about the change, you know. The same thing if you ask them, you know, like, you are going to do this, they will never do this. But if you tell them, as you said, the positive and the negative sides, if you explain them that what is good and bad, and they have to choose among it, then everybody knows that whether I'm going to the right path or wrong path, you know, and what I have to choose. So it's when I would like just like to give an example. If you say that cigarette smoking is injurious to health, we tell like that, the father tells the son, but the father is smoking in front of the son.
Exactly, yes.
So how can you tell your son that you shouldn't smoke it? But yes, you have to tell them that you have to draw a line. Okay, you can try once, but it should not be a habit. Okay, if you know that what is smoking, and of course, because you know that young children are very curious to know about it. Suppose you would tell them, the girls, that you don't have to go to disco since you're a girl, you only have to be at home and cook and all that. No, this is not the era where they are going to listen to it. And there has to be equality, no gender discrimination. So you have to allow them to go. But then there should be liberty with restrictions. And that is definitely going to help them. And they themselves are very wise and mature enough to understand that what is right and what is wrong, and whether we have to choose the positive or the negative.
Yeah, this is good, because this is a very, very, I mean, big problem nowadays. So I think we will interview again in future.
Yes.
About this problem. And thank you so much.
Thank
and
you.
All the best for today's program.
Thank you.